AirDrop is a technology that Apple invented a few years ago that allows you to easily share files and folders between Apple devices. Do we have something similar under Android? We have something brand specific, like Huawei has its Huawei Share, Xiaomi its Xiaomi Share, and Oppo and Xiaomi and Vivo and some others are working together on creating an ecosystem that allows to use the share system between different phone brands. But is there really an AirDrop competitor that you can use for transferring files from one Huawei device, for example, to a Sony device, and from the Sony device to your laptop? Yes, there is one called KDEConnect, and best of it, it's free software, it's open source software. You can just download and install it on your Android device and easily use it to share files and folders with different devices. And I will tell you how this works right now. So I have several devices here, my Mate 30 Pro, my Sony Xperia 10 Mark II, and my MatePad Pro, and another device in the back that you cannot see right now, which is my computer, and I want to connect all of them. I can use KDEConnect for this. You can find KDEConnect, of course, in Android, on Android, on the Play Store, but if you have a Huawei device like I have here, you don't have the Play Store, you can install it from AirDrop, which is a free and open source Android store, and you can just search for KDEConnect, and you can find it here and just install it. AirDrop is a very secure store, reproducible builds, and proven to be very, very stable and good, so I can recommend it to you. KDEConnect is also available for Linux. It comes pre-installed with KDE Plasma Linux distributions that ship with this desktop, and you can use it out of the box. If you start it for the first time, it will open up in the Pair New Device option, which allows you to see all the different devices that are on your network. So you need to be in the same Wi-Fi network as it is using Wi-Fi to share files and folders. As you can see here, I have various different connected devices, Xperia 1, my laptop, my Xperia 10 Mark II, my Mate 30 Pro. And I have a few other devices here that are not connected currently. If I want to connect to some device, usually it has some lists of recommendations that it needs to have access to, like if you want to share your file system or you want to be able to receive files, you have to have give it the permission to access your file system, and the same goes for certain other things as well, but it will explain it to you as well. So if I connect to one device, for example my Xperia 10 Mark II, I have various different options, not only sending files and folders, I also have the option to do a slideshow remote control. Doesn't make sense for the tablet here itself, but as a representation here I can show you this. So if you have your laptop, for example, attached to a projector and you want to give a presentation and you don't have one of those clickers, you can use a smartphone, simple as this, as a slideshow remote control. If you click on this, you have the option to go one back or one forward. So this is basically the option that it gives to you that is also controllable here if you'd like to do this. Slideshow remote, you can see. So you can use your smartphone as a remote control. And the same goes for multimedia control. You can control your smartphone's media playback. In this case, let me control my Xperia 10 Mark II because I have some videos running here in the background. Those guys here talking about Canon R5 versus Sony A7S3. But imagine that I have now a laptop or something like this sitting on a desk and I'm sitting on my sofa and the laptop is not reachable. I can just use my smartphone to control the YouTube playback just by pressing here. You can see it starts playing and I can pause it. I can also jump to the next video if you like to, and it goes to the next video of this playlist, for example. Pretty nice indeed, I would say. And you can do this also vice versa. So via the Xperia 10 Mark II, I can control my MatePad Pro or my laptop. Then you have a remote input. This doesn't work with devices like my Android. I cannot use this to control my Android device, but it works pretty nice if you want to use your keyboard here, for example, or your smartphone as a touchpad on your laptop. So it will take control of the mouse cursor and allows you to use your touchpad on your device as you can see here with this field as a mouse cursor. And you can also use the keyboard to type something in and to remotely enter stuff in on your laptop, for example. This only works with laptops and your smartphone, but it doesn't work with devices like Android devices. So let me send some files. Let me get to my Mate 30 Pro, for example, and I want to send some files. I have some pictures here, a nice file, just like, for example, this one here, a nice wallpaper. I want to share it. I click on the share option down here, and then I have the option, as you can see here, KDEConnect is going into the share options of Android as well. I can click on here and can see a list of connected devices, and I can say, okay, I want to share it with my MatePad. I click on this, and you can see it makes a sound that I received a new file. And as you can see here, I received this new file. I can click on it. You can see also a small preview here. I can click on it and it will open up the file. This works with very easily with image files. It works with movie files. It works with every files that you have, PDFs, even bigger images and bigger files as well. I use this, for example, if I record something with my Mate 30 Pro and want to edit it on my MatePad Pro, I can just simply copy it over, or I can use it also to copy it over to my laptop. So also big movie files are not a problem. So this is KDEConnect. This is the option. The cool thing is you can use it on your Linux computer. You can use it on your Android devices, but also SailfishOS devices are supported. So if you have an alternative operating system like a SailfishOS device, you can install the Android client or the native SailfishOS client and have almost all the same features available. If there are some new features, what you can do is go in here and click on plugin settings. And here you have all the plugins that are supported by KDEConnect. You can see there are lots and lots of plugins. So what I didn't show you right now is notification synchronization. So if I get some notifications on my chat application on my phone, I can also sync and automatically get it on my laptop that I'm currently working on. I have clipboard synchronization, which is very, very handy. So if I have a website that I visited on my phone and I come home now, I want to visit on my big laptop or my big tablet, what I can do, let me just go in and open a web browser, for example, Firefox Nightly, and let's open up just for fun my Linux minus podcast. If you're German speaking audience, you probably heard of my TechView podcast, the audio part, and I want to share this with my tablet. What I can do is just simply copy this. I have it now copied, and what I could do here is go into the browser, Firefox Klar in this case, Firefox Focus, and paste it in, and it would work. In this case, it's not working because I have disabled this plugin here. But what you can also do is hold this and go to share, and then you have the option to share it with your device, MatePad Pro, for example. And it will ask me how to complete the action. I say open it in the web browser, and then it will go automatically onto the page that I want to share. And this works also not with the tablet and Android devices, but also with SailfishOS device and also with the computer. So you can share your clipboard with your computer if you want to, which is also a pretty nice thing. Then we have some other things here as well. Sending a ping, which is just searching if the device is still there. Find my tablet is also such a function. Receive remote key presses, multimedia controls, big screen remote, use your device as a remote for a plasma big screen. Plasma big screen is an extra application for little Raspberry Pi like computers and multimedia centers that allow you to remote control it via your smartphone if you don't have a controller, for example. And remote input as well is supported here. Some of those have configuration options, just like Share and Receive has a configuration option where I can customize the destination directory. If my Mate 30 Pro is sending to my MatePad a file, where should it be saved? I can customize this, and I have the option also, if I don't want to get a notification about this, to disable this. And notification sync, I also have some options here, and I can select various different applications that I want to synchronize with. So if I don't want to have, like, for example, the battery warning on my desktop from my tablet, then I can disable it here, or different other warnings. So I have the option to configure this as well here. And there's some other options here. As you can see, select the ringtone for Find My Tablet, and for remote key presses, how to handle this. There are a few of those settings for remote input settings, for example, right click, left click, middle click, and so on, and reverse scrolling direction if you want to use this. So it has many, many different configuration options, and it's a pretty handy option to use when you want to use something like AirDrop, but plus a little bit more with your devices. These are the options of KDEConnect. It is very secure. It uses encryption, as you can see here, various different encryption keys that it uses for encrypting the connection. So it is also pretty safe and very fast and very good indeed. But there's one limitation. It needs to be in the same Wi-Fi. So if your smartphone is not on Wi-Fi, it will not work. So there's no Wi-Fi direct connection between those devices. They need to be on the same Wi-Fi. They use the Wi-Fi network. So this is everything for this little video. I hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching. Give it a like. Ask questions if you want to know a little bit more about KDEConnect or have a specific question. And thanks for watching. Until the next time. Bye.